One of the biggest problems in our new house is the lack of storage. There is not a coat closet or linen closet in sight. And after living with piles of coats and shoes inside of my front door for way too long, I decided it was finally time to tackle the problem. So I partnered with Craig Tools to create these beautiful mudroom lockers to store everything for our family. Since we don't have a mudroom in our home, these mudroom lockers are going right inside of our front door. So I needed a beautiful piece of furniture instead of just a utilitarian cabinet. And I created the design for these lockers to mimic the dining room hutch that I built a couple years ago. This hutch is actually across the kitchen from the entryway, so you can see both pieces of furniture at the same time. I broke down the plywood pieces for the mudroom lockers with a combination of using my table saw and using the new Craig straight edge guide. This straight edge guide is awesome because it clamps and holds tight to your cutting surface, your wood, whatever you're cutting. And then you have guides on the side that allow you to set it to where the blade is going to be. So now instead of having to measure for the cut and then measure again for the blade, you're able to do it all in one fell swoop. Once all of the pieces were cut down, it was time to add some dados for the shelves, and I needed to add these before I could start assembling. So to make life a little bit easier, I ended up clamping four of the side pieces together and just using the straight edge guide XL to do one long dado all the way across it. And then I was able to just repeat this for the second dado on the first side. And because three of the boards actually needed dados on the opposite side as well to accommodate shelves off both sides, I swapped out one of the boards with the other sideboard and then flipped over the other three and repeated for dados on the other side. And I loved how I was able to quickly change the blade line for my straight edge guide to where the bottom of my router bit would be. So setting up for each set of dados was super easy. The sides are held into the cabinet with dados, but the top and the bottom pieces, as well as the inner support pieces, are held in with pocket holes. So I used the new Craig Jig 720 to add pocket holes to all of these pieces before assembling. And after all that prep work, now came the exciting part where the cabinet started coming together. Now, assembling this is pretty simple. The main important things are making sure that all of the corners come in square so that your whole cabinet ends up square. And I started by attaching the top and the bottom with my pocket hole screws. The top I used some Craig corner clamps that are really great and easy for creating corners. However, the bottom is set up 4.5 inches so that there can be a base on the bottom. So I used a right angle guide that I have created myself, and that helped keep my boards square as I attached them. Then I attached my support pieces and I put those right below the dados where the shelves would go. And these just help keep the whole cabinet square and hold it together. And it also gives the shelf something to sit on. Also, that top support piece is very important in that it gives your back of your cabinet the thickness needed to add a hook. Once the pieces for the first cabinet box were attached with pocket holes, I used some wood glue to slide my shelves into the dados, and then I attached the second side of that first locker section. And the most important thing for this is making sure that you're lining up the correct dados. The top shelf of the cabinets are not even all the way across, so you want to line up the right dado and then make sure that the second dado is the opposite one. And for the lower section, they are all the same. When you are moving those pieces, there is a little bit of a weak point until everything's glued together where the two dados are on the bottom, because you only have 1/4 inch left inside. So just be careful when moving those so that you don't end up breaking it along that weak point. Once all the pieces were lined up, it was as easy as attaching it to the first side with some pocket hole screws and wood glue. Again, making sure to keep everything nice and square. And with the first locker section complete, it was just a quick assembly line to add the rest of the locker sections. So I ended up creating the first two sections by repeating this exact same process, adding the top and bottom and side supports to another piece, and then attaching it to the assembled locker section. Then I created a second section with another completed locker and a side attached to it. Then I was able to put the two together. This completed locker is quite large and heavy, so it made it easy to create it in two sections and then put those two sections together. Even with building the locker in two separate pieces and then attaching the two pieces together, these are very large and kind of heavy pieces. So a second set of hands would have been helpful. I didn't have the opportunity to rely on my husband this day because he was busy running some errands. So I was able to manage by using quite a few clamps. Clamps were my best friend with building this larger piece. One thing that is important to note as you are assembling this cabinet, and it's something you should pay attention to when you start drilling pocket holes, because you are attaching two pieces on one side of a 3/4 inch plywood. If your pocket holes line up perfectly on both sides, you will actually not be able to attach them together because you will be hitting the previous screw. And I had this happen only in two places because I didn't think about it before I drilled my pocket holes. So I want to tell you to drill your pocket holes to make sure that all of them on the left side are maybe a half an inch off from all of them on the right side. That way when you go to assemble, you don't have to worry about them being on top of each other. With the cabinet build finished, it was time to turn my attention to building the face frame. Now, the face frame is really easy to put together, but it is large, so you do want to make sure you have a large flat surface to assemble it on. And the face frame is made up of rails and stiles. The rails are the pieces that will cover the front of the shelves and the top and the bottom. And the stiles are the vertical pieces that cover the sides and all of the separators between the lockers. So you will attach your pocket holes to all of the rails, and then it's just a matter of attaching it all together. A couple tips for creating your face frame is you always want to make sure you use a face frame clamp on the rails and stiles when you are attaching them. This will hold the pieces completely flat, so you will get a nice flush front to your face frame. The next step is when you are attaching a rail to the top or bottom of a stile where you are going to be attaching the screws close to the edge of a board. It does have a tendency to split, so always attach the screw closest to the edge of the board first, then attach the next one, because if you do it the opposite way, you are more likely to have splitting occur. Also, since this face frame is going to be covering the front of my shelves, and as much as I measured twice and cut once, my shelves may not be completely perfect. So I set all of my face frame rails about 1/4 inch higher than the bottom of the shelf. This does give me a little bit of a lip on the front of the shelves, but it is not very noticeable. But what it is noticeable is that I don't have to worry about it not covering the complete front of my plywood cabinet. So once I got going with this face frame, it was just a matter of clamping and attaching all of the boards in order to have one perfect flat face frame. Not only does the style of the cabinet mimic the hutch in the dining room, but the paint job also mimics it. I painted the outside and the face frame of the mudroom cabinet, and then the inside I left as a natural wood and just protected it with a wax seal. Since I wanted the outside painted and the inside the wood look, I decided it would be way easier to paint the face frame before attaching it to the cabinet. I also finished the inside of my mudroom cabinet with wax before attaching. So after I got all of the painting and finishing done and let it dry, it was time to attach the face frame. Now the face frame is attached with wood glue and brad nails. And I also have the face frame completely assembled out of 1x2s. So it ends up overlapping the sides about 3/8 of an inch on either side. And this is going to be flush cut later on. But when attaching it, it's just very important to make sure that it is perfectly centered on the cabinet. Don't try to flush up one side first because then it won't be centered. I used a flush cut router bit inside of my palm router and used it to flush up the side of the cabinet. Now, because I am flush cutting a 3/8 of an inch, I did it in multiple little passes so that I did not break and tear out any of the wood. And the final piece of the cabinet is adding a base. This will cover up the bottom. It will bring the base of the cabinet up off of the floor just a little bit, which I like, so I'm not leaning down as much. And it completely closes off the front, so I don't have to worry about kids losing things underneath the cabinet, which I'm sure would be full of dust and lost flip-flops if it was left open. So I'm using just 1x4 boards, and I cut them at a miter and attach them to the front and the sides of the cabinet with the brad nails as well. And with the final piece of the cabinet assembled, it was time to finish painting, and I was able to paint the sides. I also touched up the top where I had any nail holes from attaching the face frame. I went back and forth on whether or not I wanted to add a back to my mudroom cabinets. And with the cabinet completely assembled, I decided I did want to add a 1/4 inch plywood back to the area of the cabinet that had the hanging storage in it. This is more visible, and I didn't want to see the wall behind it. So I used my palm router again with a 1/4 inch bit in it and was able to do a quick rabbit around the backing area and attach a piece of 1/4 inch plywood. And with that, my mudroom cabinet was finished. All that was left to do was to add some hooks and load it up with all of our stuff. I added 3 hooks to each locker compartment, one on the back wall into that upper support piece, and one on each side wall. This gave plenty of space for all of the coats and hats and backpacks, umbrellas, and anything else my family had that was needed to be stored by the front door. I also used large bins in the bottom compartment for shoes, and these are large enough to hold more shoes than anybody in our family really needs to have. And I absolutely love the way it turned out. And even more importantly, I love the organization that came with it. Now, I am sharing the full detailed plans for this on the Craig Tool website under their projects. I'll have a link to it below so you can build your own mudroom cabinet. And definitely make sure to hit that like button. And if you liked this video, hit subscribe so you can follow along as I create more DIYs for the home.